Hello, my name is Isaiah Garcia, and I am a senior here at Texas Tech University. I'll be receiving my degree in microbiology with a minor in chemistry and Spanish. Today, I have the honor of presenting my thesis to you by explaining the processes that went into it, the essential argument, and the conclusions that I came to find. My thesis is entitled "The Suicide-Related Stigma Among Young Adults with Bipolar Disorder." This thesis is about stigma among a large group of people. It is also about how we can reduce the stigma among that group of people. And lastly, it's about how this population can avoid seeking help sometimes at physicians' offices because of the stigma. And I wrote this thesis as a way to help me broaden my horizons over this topic. I want to be a doctor who serves and treats all types of patients. And if I'm not able to relate to those patients, or if I'm not able to understand where they're coming from, I don't think that I'll be able to treat them the way that they deserve. So I wrote this thesis as a way to help me in my future become the best doctor that I can. To begin the discussion of my thesis, I will be addressing the problem. Suicide is the 10th leading cause of death worldwide. And to put this into perspective, the World Health Organization found that for every 40 seconds, one person will die by suicide. In the amount of time that I have been speaking already, 2 to 3 people have died by suicide. It is even scary to think that this impact is elevated among the group of young adults who suffer from bipolar disorder and who are stigmatized for having that disorder. It is even scarier to think that this is seen to affect the help-seeking behavior of these group of people in going to primary care physicians' offices. And this is the problem that I'll be discussing throughout my entire thesis, is how do we reduce the amount of stigma and suicide seen among this group of people? To answer this question, I organized my thoughts into four major sections. The first section was about risk factors, specifically among those who have bipolar disorder and who have suicide ideations or suicidal thoughts. This section discussed the factors that could lead to the generation and cultivation of stigma among this group of people. Of the many factors that I discussed, some of the main ones were the quality of a person's life and the social relationships that they may have. And it can be seen, or perhaps thought of, that if they are both negative and/or toxic, it could lead to the generation of stigma. Next, I discussed the healthcare models that are seen and used in the primary care facilities. Of the many that I found, I thought that the ecological model was the one that was best suited for treating this group of people. This model brings up the idea of multiple levels of impact. This is the idea that there are multiple levels of influence that a person's life revolves around, and that each one contributes to their health and overall betterment. I found that the levels of impact that are most impactful are the level of the individual person, the societal level, and the systemic level, that is, the primary care facility level. In the next section, I discuss barriers that perhaps inhibit the prevention of suicide and stigma, and I use the ecological model of healthcare as a framework to frame these barriers better. For example, in the level of the individual, I found that the most pressing barriers to be stigma, which is perceived or self-stigma. Perceived stigma is the idea of what you think the stigma of society is, and self-stigma is stigma that you have on yourself, that you constantly give yourself a bad rap. Then other factors could be the lack of trust with PCPs, whether that is primary care physicians, or the lack of accurate health knowledge with the system itself, and others. For the level of society, the most pressing barrier that I found was the presence of public stigma. That is the actual stigma that society gives you as a person who is stigmatized. And lastly, the level of the primary care system, I found that the most pressing barriers are lack of training for primary care physicians to treat those with mental health symptoms and a lack of accurate mental health screenings in general. I also had the pleasure of interviewing Dr. Sarah Victor and Dr. Paul Ingram in interviews discussing the barriers at each level of impact. The barriers that I had presented are mostly in support of what they had said. Lastly, I discussed in my fourth section the solutions that I believe could best treat these patients. I believe that for the level of the individual, that we should enhance the development of trust between the patient and the physician. This will create a long-lasting reduction of stigma and establish a strong physician-patient rapport. Secondly, I believe that education of young adults through school-based interventions held by primary care physicians could reduce the amount of stigma and increase the likelihood of primary care visits, which I believe could increase the opportunities for suicide risk screenings. And lastly, I believe that the training of physicians, specifically primary care physicians, about mental health symptoms and suicide risk through consistent attendance of seminars would create a future of culture of anti-stigma. This concludes my thesis presentation. I would like to say thank you so much for listening to it, and I hope that you have a great rest of your day.